Indianapolis. I'm Joe Tessitore. We're glad to be bringing you action and welcoming you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada for tonight's main event. 12 rounds of lightweight action. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W. Vargas's ring walk is one of those ring walks where you realize how attentive this fighter is. This is a guy who has his eye on the prize and nothing will distract him. The Brown Bomber's confidence is really showing through as he makes his way to the ring. Protecting himself.
Those are feet!
What's the worst kind of situation you can get yourself into when you're fighting a guy who you know has superior hands?
You start thinking too much, Joe. You start second-guessing yourself. You start being a little hesitant.
And he's holding. Vargas's left working well that time.
Good job!
You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. Vargas's left landing well. Able to cover up that gut. Vargas is just punching air that time. His opponent was able to get out of the way. Good job staying away from the danger there. That right hand by Vargas. Wow, what an uppercut.
Good work.
The Brown Bomber's last round to me, Teddy, completely ineffective. His accuracy way off the mark, throwing punches, but lost the round.
Joe, talking about being off the mark. If you're traveling outside your laws, you need a map to find your way. He needs a map right now to find his way. He needs some direction.
Just breathe. Relax. How you feeling out there? Now, you're not winning.
Here we go. Round two is underway. And landing him.
I think he has a date and he wants to get to it.
And you can see he wanted to do that as he holds on there. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Vargas's jab lands well. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by the Brown Bomber. Reaching the halfway mark. Vargas is thumped by a left hand.
Stay with me here.
Hey, I know he's not in great shape, but he's doing a very good job now all of a sudden of defending himself. Scored well up top.
I see that coming. Let's go.
Solid shot, the overhand left. A little head hunting with the right. He missed with that headshot.
Keep working the body.
Final 10 seconds of round number two. We come to the end of round number two. The Brown Bombers got to find a way to land more of these punches. It's okay to throw punches, but not if they're just drifting off the space.
Absolutely, and space is it. He's in space. He's too far away. He has to get the right range.
He took a shot, but he came back with a right hand of his own.
Nice!
Went to the body there, but unable to connect. Good shot to the head with that right hand. Oh, good defense there. That was a fine block by Vargas. Vargas is being very patient here, but it's with a plan in mind.
Yeah, it is with a plan in mind, and that's why he's such a successful fighter. He's trying to lure his opponent into a mistake.
Of this 3-minute round. And now he's acting like a fighter, coming back with the right hand after getting scored upon.
Duck at him!
Scorecard. He's trailing 3 rounds to zip, Teddy. People will be looking at this and say, yeah, but he's throwing punches. But, Teddy, it's about throwing clean, effective punches.
Exactly. And it's about not standing in front of your opponent after you punch and waiting for the receipt.
He just missed that shot up top. Great movement to get away from those punches.
That's it! One, two! That's it!
I like that step back right there. Just enough to be out of danger, but still close enough to then land the counter punch.
Well, that's what happens when you have that kind of experience. You're calm enough to know that range. Know where the beginning of the punch and the end of the punch is.
Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. The left hand coming into play by Vargas. Parries that punch intended for the head. Oh, that's good stuff. Fired right back with one of his own. Good work by Vargas. spinning now to the left hand. Good straight shot. Vargas's defense is paying off now. The Brown Bomber's giving his opponent headaches here now. He's throwing punches, but he's able to block them away.
Keep moving.
And all of a sudden, the tables turn. Vargas is rocked.
Get out of
there. What's good for you is good for him.
What a revealing round we just saw. Each man was able to hurt the other. You really can tell how much is on the line here between these two.
Yeah, they both came here. I mean, they're in the best shape of their career. They came here understanding what this fight means.
Vargas's movement helped out there. He avoided that punch. Teddy, there are opportunities that are here for him, aren't there?
Yeah, counterpunch opportunities, because he's got an opponent who's walking in a little bit. Now he has a chance to start to chuck something back at him a little.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Shot.
That's it, just like that.
Halfway into round number five here. Goes up top with a right hand.
Side of the road where they removed all the tires, all the wheels. He's not going anywhere.
This round comes to an end. A round in which this fighter threw a lot of punches, didn't land a lot of punches. I'll tell you, what advice can you give to him if you're the trainer?
Well, first of all, deal with the psychological part. Joe, don't forget, 75% of this game is psychological. Don't let him get discouraged, because even though he's not going to say nothing, in his head he's starting to get discouraged. Just say to him, hey, listen, you're going to catch him. Let's shorten him up a little bit. And you know what? He's moving his head, so go to the body. Because now you're going to hit him a little in the body, because the body's not moving.
Two good jab by Vargas. And now just wasting away some time with that clinch. Overhand right. Halfway through round six.
Hey, keep your feet moving.
Vargas is tagged by that punch. The Brown Bomber's showing us that he's aggressive, but this is not a good kind of aggression. You can be countered this way.
Yeah, it's a reckless aggression. You know, he's just walking in there, you know, with these big wide punches. Something's going to come in between.
That is a big right hand after eating one himself. Piercing uppercut by Vargas. Good solid overhand left. Vargas is almost looking foolish that time he missed so badly. The Brown Bombers able to land a good, solid left hand. Working our way towards the bell, last 10 seconds of the sixth.
Don't let him get to you!
I like the way he looked at the end of that round. Looks like he's gaining some momentum here. Good competitive fight. And I do believe that he's up on the scorecard.
Got that? Yeah, I have to the same way.
You have to double that.
Well, the ability to adapt, so important. Who can make the changes now as we're halfway through this scheduled 12-rounder? And now he brings the left hand upstairs. Hits him in the mug with the right. And there he counters back against his opponent. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Vargas. Well, you can see what he wanted to do there, but unable to land that body shot. Vargas has been able to avoid having any of his opponent's headshots landing flush.
And what his opponent has to do, Joe, is make an adjustment. What we used to tell the fighters, when a guy's elusive like this fighter is right now, you have to shorten your punches up. Shorten them up a little bit, have less space to travel. They have a better chance of getting to that elusive target.
Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot.
In and out, in and out. You got this one.
Devastating hook by Vargas.
Back to the body.
10 seconds to go in the seventh.
Keep doing what you're doing. Keep the jab bumping, then throw the lead right hand. You're winning this fight. This is it. You hurt him, keep on it.
Start of round number eight. Vargas is in control, according to Teddy's scorecard. The busier guy, really, when you look at the totality of this fight, that's the way to describe it. He's been the busier guy.
Yeah, he's been working when the other guy's not working. And in close rounds, that's enough to get him, at least on my card.
Good right hand. The Brown Bombers left, working well that time. Vargas's objective is to land that jab, and he did so right there. The Brown Bombers able to land a nice clean left hand. Showing you some defense there with the block. Vargas is swinging and missing like he's at bat right there. That punch was nowhere near his opponent. The halfway point of round number eight.
Work the body, Dick! Body shot!
Vargas is missing the mark by a mile. That just was nowhere to be found. Here's something that's a key factor now, and that is his ability to simply defend himself. He's doing a wonderful job at it.
Yeah, he is, and that gives him the ability to always be fresh and confident round after round since he's not taking a lot of punishment.
Clock counting down here in round number eight. 10 seconds to go. This has been a very entertaining fight. A little time to reflect here at the end of this round. My thoughts being this. I would really be surprised if we go to a decision here. It just has that kind of feel to it.
Yeah, it has a feel to me like going to one of those places where you can eat all the pasta you can for one price, you know? And some guys get carried away. They eat about five bowls. Well, these guys, they're going to have a stomachache at the end. Somebody is going to wind up not standing at the end.
He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Good step back counter punch there.
That's okay. Stay in back.
Seconds into the ninth round. That is a sharp uppercut by the Brown Bomber. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. No, he missed that right. Defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Final chance, last 10 seconds of round 9. The Brown Bomber's got to be in control of things after that round. This is a good fight, very good fight. I give his opponent credit, but I do believe he's ahead on the scorecards.
Yeah, but you want to keep that carrot out in front of him. Keep running after something, you know? The worst thing is all of a sudden he thinks he's got the carrot, and he's sitting there, he's chomping away at it, and guess what? The tortoise goes right past him. Or in this case, his opponent gets his hand missing.
Vargas has got to find an answer for this because his accuracy has been well off the mark. I like the fact he's willing to throw, but he needs to land more.
Yeah, he needs to calm down and think more.
Come on, keep walking.
Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. Good flush, straight left hand. Halfway through round 10. The trigger on that overhand left.
Keep moving.
That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by the Brown Bomber. Vargas is really in position to control things in this fight if he can do what he did just there, and that's land a good solid jab.
Bad and body.
Strike after catching one by the Brown Bomber. The jab has been able to carry the night for him so far. Why so, Teddy?
Well, first of all, he's been able to get it off at the right time. His opponent, that sweet spot. You know, you hear about that in baseball. You want to just hit that ball in the sweet spot. Well, the jab, he's catching his opponent just as he's starting to get into his range before he can get off.
3 minutes gone by in this round.
All right. You are dominating this fight. Keep it up. Just keep doing what you're doing. All right, listen, you need to create more counters, okay? Slip his punch, then throw a straight right down the middle.
I'll look over at Teddy's scorecard to start this 11th round. The Brown Bombers enjoying a slight lead. It's been the past few rounds that have gotten him there. He has put together consecutive rounds to take control of this fight.
And the way he's done it kind of reminds me when you were a kid in the playground on the seesaw. Remember that? You know, you're on that seesaw going up and down, but there's one guy that's in control of going up and down.
That's right.
And that's that guy.
The bigger guy, usually.
Exactly.
He needs to improve the accuracy a little bit. That was comical by Vargas.
Stop focusing!
Has been stunned.
Hold him, damn it. Hold him.
Oh, he's hurt. He was hurt right there, but now he's grabbing on like it's a life preserver.
And he's going to have to stay there if he's going to get through these rapids.
Good block. The Brown Bomber's keeping his guard up very, very well. Teddy, does it help to have the speed that he has?
Sure. Anytime you have speed, and you can put it into the equation where whatever you're doing, it has to be technically right, but now you put speed, you're doing it even better. You're doing it at a higher level.
Two snapping jabs by Vargas. Not able to land the headshot. How about a return to sender with the left hand? Right to the head with that right. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Last 10 seconds of this 11th round. End of the round, and he's had better rounds in the fight than the one we just saw, but still, it's very much there for the take.
Yeah, whoever finishes off strongly in the late parts of these rounds, a lot of times, you know, the judges get mesmerized a little bit here, too. You know, it's a real close fight, and you kind of forgot where the separation was. And whoever grabs the last part of the round, that's who you...
Oh! He is leveled! How could he possibly get up from that? He's not going to! This fight's over! It's over! Sometimes that's all it takes. Just one good punch to end the evening. Vargas is a knockout victim here tonight.
One good punch and one mistake at the wrong time.
It was a good one indeed. And for Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us. We'll see you next time at the fights.